Hello, chocolate friends. Today I'm going to talk about something that is not really related, chocolate related, but interesting if you are curious about taste or if you lead tastings, it might be useful. So, a chemical compound called phenylthiocarbamide or phenylthiourea is infused into this paper testing strip. Why is this particular compound interesting? Well, let me tell you a story. One that would probably make most OSHA or lab safety directors cringe a lot. So, in the 1930s, a chemist named Arthur Fox was working in a DuPont lab in New Jersey. He was trying to purify phenylthiocarbamide, which I'll call PTC because that's a mouthful to say every time. He had just synthesized it, and it was a fine white powder that they were using in formulas to make a blue dye. While he was doing this, some of the PTC powder flew around the lab. And his colleague, Carl Noller, a visiting Stanford professor, inhaled some of the compound and complained of it being bitter. Fox, who was obviously closer, was like, "Dude, what are you talking about? This doesn't taste like anything at all. I don't think it's the powder." So, scientists being scientists, they repeated the test on themselves. Tasting things and licking rocks, it's kind of a scientific compulsion. In the original paper, published in 1932, Fox reported it in this way, and this is funny. Some time ago, the author had occasion to prepare a quantity of phenylthiocarbamide, and while placing it in the bottle, the dust flew around the air. Another occupant of the laboratory, Dr. C. R. Noller, complained of the bitter taste of the dust, but the author, who was much closer, observed no taste and so stated. He even tasted some of the crystals and assured Dr. Noller that they were tasteless, but Dr. Noller was equally certain it was the dust he had tasted. So he tried some of the crystals and found them extremely bitter. I think this is hilarious. I can just imagine the interaction that went on in the lab at the time. So they were curious, was this just us or was it other people too? So they went about asking their colleagues, their family members, their friends to taste the powder as well. Fox wrote, "With these two diverse observations as a starting point, a large number of people were investigated, and it was established that this peculiarity was not connected with age, race, or sex." Interestingly, they found that most people fall into just one of two categories, which they refer to by the obvious terms, tasters and non-tasters. To further test the phenomenon, Fox had a booth at the American Association for the Advancement of Science in 1932, and he set up kind of a voting machine where he had invited people to taste the PTC and vote whether or not they tasted bitter. So, in the 1930s, scientists mostly believed that everyone tasted the same way. We all tasted the same things. So, this was kind of a big deal. The infamous yet incorrect tongue map that we're all familiar with was not published until 1942. And even today, we still have an incomplete understanding of taste and flavor. However, Fox's discovery caught the eye of other scientists as well, who were working on Mendelian genetics. You have probably learned in high school about Mendelian genetics, about the monk Gregor Mendel, who worked with pea plants to develop these ideas about genetics. And he is considered the father of modern genetics. Words like recessive, dominant, homozygous, heterozygous, alleles, genes, these all ringing a bell. Those are all terms that are used in Mendelian genetics. PTC sensitivity is one of the best known Mendelian traits in human population genetics. And much of its appeal in classroom and tastings comes from this very fact. It is nearly impossible to guess ahead of time if one will be able to taste or not taste the bitter compound. Yet when tested, or when you taste the paper indicator, the difference is so striking, it is entirely entertaining, both for me to watch and for the people who are tasting. So you can buy PTC tasting strips from biological supply stores, and online you can buy them. They're used in this way. It's really quite simple. So you have a small tasting strip. You don't eat it. You do not swallow it. You simply place it on your tongue, and virtually immediately you will either taste bitter or not. It does not take time. It doesn't get stronger over time. Sometimes when I do tastings, I have a control strip of paper that I make people taste first, because some people will be convinced that it's the way the paper tastes, and it is definitely not. It is either you can taste it or not. So it took 70 years to figure out what was going on with this PTC paper. In the meantime, the genetic association was so strong for this little paper strip testing that it was used in paternity testing prior to the wide availability of DNA testing. So first, in 1999, there was a discovery of a specific group of bitter taste receptors on the tongue. This led to many people testing those taste receptors against PTC. It wasn't until 2003 that the TAS2R38 gene locus, the 38th member of the 2R family of bitter taste receptors, was shown to account for the variation in the ability to taste PTC. Three nucleotides are the difference between being able to taste and being not able to taste. Roughly 70 to 75% of the population will taste the bitter compound. It is conferred by at least one copy of the allele of the gene. So both homozygous tasters, two copies of the allele, and heterozygous tasters, only one copy, will taste it. Homozygous non-tasters will taste absolutely nothing. Some people think that having two copies of the allele, the tasting allele, will make you taste it more intensely than just one, and they may refer to those individuals as super tasters. There is some evidence that the ability to taste PTC is linked to dietary preferences. While PTC does not occur in food, people who can taste PTC are less likely to smoke, less likely to drink coffee, less likely to eat bitter fruits and vegetables, things like Brussels sprouts, broccoli, cabbage. They may also be more sensitive to sweet as well. So in recent years, there has been some evidence that some evidence of the toxicity of PTC. And many people will use what are called prop testing strips instead of PTC. While it tests for a different chemical compound, it still has similar dramatic results. So it would be the same if you used it. But in any case, PTC on the paper is so intensely bitter that it requires such a tiny amount on the paper to be detectable that it is significantly below the published toxicity levels. So this is a fun thing to do if you're in a classroom or in a tasting session that really allows you to convey an understanding and talk more about the science behind tasting and the time that has gone into understanding how taste works. So it's a different thing to introduce into your tastings that you do. Again, really simple. You just place it on your tongue. You can taste it or not. I personally have done this many, many times, and it does taste very bitter to me. So I know I'm particularly sensitive to bitter in chocolate for sure, but also bitter in other foods as well. So I can guess that I have two copies of the allele. Do I know for sure? No, I do not. But something fun to do in your tastings if you want to include a little more sciencey aspect to it in addition to the chocolate, or if you just want to try it on your friends and family for fun one day. So if you have any questions about PTC or prop papers or where to get them, let me know in the comments. If you know something weird about taste that you want to share with me, your taste, other people's taste, fun trivia facts, share it in the comments. Otherwise, that's it for this week's video, and next week we'll talk more about all things having to do with chocolate. I hope to see you then. Thanks for watching.